Hi, I'm Dave.
And I'm Craig.
It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review on this week's show. Right, first up this week is a guy. I don't know if we're too popular with this guy because we reviewed another one of his products, didn't we? It's Michael Chatterlane.
He's very hit and miss. He's like Marmite.
Right.
You know, we hate him. Yeah, we hated the lame. Or the lame, as you...
The lame, yeah.
But we liked his Torn and Restored Card thing.
Yeah, Rewind. That was pretty good.
A lot of buzz about this on the forums.
A lot of people have actually got in touch with us through our Facebook site, facebook.com/worldmagicshop, and asked us to review this. Yep. And on the CAF as well, we've had many private messages. People want the lowdown on this. It's speed. What did you reckon first, Craig? I've got an opinion, but what do you reckon?
It's pretty good. I mean, you got the Hawk that came out a while ago, and I really did not like that. I thought it was angly and just not commercial at all.
Yeah.
This is more commercial than the Hawk.
Right.
It does what it says on the tin. You know, you put a card into the middle of the deck, face up. You tap the top of the deck with either another playing card or a credit card or whatever. It visually comes up to the top, and it actually really does look good when it works.
Yeah, it's a little bit fiddly, isn't it? You don't get it out of the box and it's working straight away. Basically, you've got a couple of gimmick cards here. I've got a problem with this straight away. If I'm going to do an ambitious card routine, I need this really to fit in with my existing ambitious card. Unfortunately, I'm stuck in my ways. This is something I've done for years, and I suddenly can't put in two very, very thick cards just to accomplish this effect at the end. I just can't do that.
If you could just have one card and use a credit card. He does have an option for gimmick up a credit card, but still, with that one card in the deck, you're not going to be able to use any other ambitious card moves. You're just going to be able to have to do this one phase of magic.
Well, you can do tilts and that sort of thing, but you know, you can't riffle through the deck. It stops you from doing so many things. And if you want to do it straight away, you've got to introduce these two new cards into the deck. This is a problem for me straight away. It's the problem I had with the Hawk. It's why I prefer WoW 2, I'm afraid, because you can do your existing... ambitious card routine, and then it seems to be like a logical step forward then, that you're sleight of hand proof in the deck, like the original Daryl presentation.
And you're using a regular deck.
You've got the blank WoW on the bottom and then the face down WoW on the top, and as the finale they see it change. But these things are introduced in full view, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah,
you're actually justifying
you're
the props.
Yeah.
And for this, it's not covert.
I know that you branded, you said to me that this is a new type of magic that seems to be coming up a lot at the moment, which is magic for a YouTube webcam.
Magic for YouTube, you know, it's the sort of thing, 10-second clip, looks brilliant. Out in the real world at the residency, I don't think you're going to use this. It's a lot better than the lame, but...
Yeah, I'm not going to do this. I mean, I thought that the gimmick was broken. You know, I thought... And maybe if you work with it... But nah.
I'm only going to give this 48%.
Yeah, I think I'll give it probably 55. It's not worth getting.
You might like it, but it's not really commercial. Right, Craig, I don't know if you noticed, Droopy's actually doing his own review today.
There he is, over there.
This is an idea, Phony Magnet by Eric Buss. Now, he had it out a few years ago. This is not a brand new product, but it's redesigned because it's got the iPhone now.
Right.
This is ideal for cabaret performers. If you hear a phone go off in the audience, you go over with the magnet.
Go into their jacket. And it looks like you pull the phone out of their jacket. It's really funny.
It is good. It's a good heckler stopper. It doesn't need a long, massive review. Droopy certainly likes it. The props are excellent. It's not cheap, but it's very, very well
made. Droopy told me earlier he gave it 90%.
Droopy's given it 90%. Right, on to this. Now, let me read this to you. This is awesome. This packaging certainly caught my eye. Anything that's got hands like this... And something
which,
floating.
Like most of your DVDs.
Something floating in the middle. Don't bring my DVDs into this. Don't dare.
Okay.
Right. The ultimate levitation principle.
Go on, I'm listening.
No magnets, no threads, no wires. And this is... he's just got like a borrowed note, and it just floats up off his hand,
Dave,
an inch and a quarter.
Does it float or does it wobble?
Well, it's not quite as good as it sounds. Like we mentioned earlier, magic for YouTube. This definitely is magic for YouTube. What did you think of this?
I've got to be honest. It's just, I don't really want to sit here and rant on another product, but I'm going to sit here and rant on another product. This is absolute crap. It's really bad. The big hint here is that he hasn't put his name on the front of the DVD.
He's called Wall, though. We checked.
But we found it. His name's Wall.
Oh, by the way, we call it a DVD. 12 minutes?
12 minutes. And three of those minutes, it's almost like you're on a trip. It's the weirdest 3 minutes you'll ever experience.
Yeah, it's like he's on a train, and then there's this bizarre bit where it's just showing some like digital signs and that, but it's not arty, like a paper crane DVD or anything like
good.
That.
No, it's nothing like that.
It's like he's in a rubbish dump doing the trick.
And then you've got the real world performance of it.
Well, there isn't one.
No, it's just him there with his hand going.
Yeah, because you can't perform it in the real world. You can perform it for is a camera that's looking at it from a YouTube video.
Remember what you said about it?
Oh. Nearly invisible. The gimmick is nearly invisible. Mind you, I couldn't actually see much on the DVD because the focus was going in and out all the time.
Oh yeah, he's filmed it on a webcam, like nothing but high production. This is not a big blind media release. This is. I don't even know who.
Now it says no threads, right? The problem with this, Michael Amar put a version out many years ago. Late 70s or something, I don't know.
Yeah.
He had hair. It was incredible. And he did the floating note.
Yep.
And he did the floating note, and it's just a beautiful, simple presentation.
Yep.
The static, it floats a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get fooled by the fact it says no threads. That's a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
We're not trying to fool magicians here.
We're not.
I say this so many times.
Yep.
We're trying to fool the public.
Yep.
And at the end of the day, there are other versions that are better. And just because this guy's come up with a method using a piddly little bit of plastic and he calls it new, don't fall for it. This is trash.
We shouldn't even review this. This isn't a review. This is a public service announcement to the viewers of the Wizard Product Review. Here's your announcement. Don't buy this.
Don't
be suckered to spend your money on this. It's absolute, complete and total trash. And whoever the hell you are, MrTrickDownload.com, how you had the audacity to release this pile of crap on people that are spending their money and on saving money.
Just put it in the bin, Craig. Get it in there. It won't even go in the bin.
Trash of the week.
Don't buy that.
Hey, I'm Ben Harris, and I've had a dream. A dream of the guys, the lads, at Wizard FX headquarters, World Magic Shop. Will they review my gear, my books, my products? Or is it just a silly, silly premonition? Over to you, lads. We sent them a carton of a Foster's and a bottle of Jack. Cool. Okay.
Right, thank you, Ben. We did get a few products coming in, and thank you very much for the beer, which mysteriously disappeared from the office.
Wouldn't know anything about that.
And I haven't seen any bottles of Jack Daniels either.
Really? I'm sure they're around somewhere.
Okay. This came in, and this really intrigued me, the plot of this.
I haven't even looked at this.
And I had a look at this morning, and I can actually do it already.
Oh, you can do it already?
I'm very impressed with this. At the end of the night, when somebody says, show me something special, you do the impossible.
Okay, well, show me the impossible then.
Right, okay.
Mr.
First
I've opened it up half an hour ago, I can do it already.
Regular deck.
Okay.
They're all different. Can I...
When's that S-Fan DVD of yours coming out?
The S-Fan. We have this joke about me, because when I'm performing, I do the S-Fan all the time. I have to do a trailer, and they're all different.
Yep.
We can give the deck a bit of a shuffle as well. That's fair, yeah?
It's fair.
And I'm just going to arrange the cards like that. And I just want you, in a second, to... cut the cards.
Okay.
When you've cut the cards, look at the card, show the camera as well, because I'm actually going to leave the room.
Okay.
This is impossible, right? Show the card to the camera, then I want you to turn it face up, put it back into the face down deck, assemble everything, but face up, like an invisible deck sort of thing, and then put it back in the box.
Are you serious?
Yeah. So
and you're going to leave the room?
I'm going to leave the room.
Oh, get out.
I hope it works, Ben. I hope I do it justice. Right. I'm going out. I'm actually going out. And I can't see.
There's no way this is going to
work. I'm going out now.
Okay,
shall
bye.
Back in when
I will. There's no way this is going to work. Okay. There we go. Hope you can all see it. There's absolutely no way this is going to work. I haven't even seen this. But he said he's going to fool me. There's no way he's going to get that. Okay, Dave.
Right, ready for this?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I know you know... But they probably don't believe. You cannot see into this office. We've got one window. It's all blacked out. You cannot see.
It's impossible.
So at the moment, the card is face up.
Dave, yeah? I'm deadly serious. There is no way you're going to... If you can do this, I'm going to freak out.
Right, so it's x-ray. So I've got to get... Just look through the... It's a black card, isn't it?
Yes. 50-50.
It's a club?
Yes.
Are you getting scared now?
Yep. Still.
It's a high card, isn't it?
Ish. Yeah.
It's the nine of clubs.
Oh, get lost.
Right, but this isn't it, right? Just gotta look. I'm gonna say 32 as I look through the card box. I'm gonna say 32. Take the cards out of the box.
What?
And count down to the 32nd card.
There is no way.
Face, start face down, but deal them into face up. That's it. Keep
going. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. Get stuff!
Worker of the week, I do believe, from Ben Harris.
How the hell did you do that? No, seriously, give me that. Hang on, let me... Could I cut anywhere?
You can cut anywhere. Different positions, you can cut anywhere.
Is
seriously.
It like a memorised deck?
Not a memorised deck.
Is there a stack?
No, not a stack.
Is it a normal deck?
Nothing.
Are there any gimmicks?
You've got to look, no exposure. No, look, it's a regular deck. You just get the pamphlet and you do it with a regular deck.
How long
That's
did it,
it
take you to learn that?
Worker of the Week took me 20 minutes to read. There's lots of bonus stuff in the back. I haven't had time to go through it. But why the hell do you need bonus stuff when you got a routine like that?
I'm going to rate this just...
I'm giving it 90. It's not for everywhere. It's for that special moment. That's the only reason I'm going to give this a little bit less. It's getting Worker of the Week and I'm giving it 94%. Because it fooled Craig Petty and I knew it would fool him.
Stuff that. It's getting 99%. I don't care. How is that... Give me the book. I'm going. See ya.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. You can follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/worldmagicshop. You can follow us on YouTube at youtube.com/worldmagicshop. And you can follow us on the Murphy's Magic Community and wizardfx.tv. We'll see you next week on the Wizard Product Review.
Whoa. To see.
It's amazing. It's stunning.